So in the year 2016, around 76,000 families were expanded and separated due to deportation. And I want to inform you guys about the everyday lives and the hardship that these people have to go through every day just by staying in this country. I've personally witnessed this many times, and it is not a very interesting thing to see. Seeing all these families devastated, sad, it just made me view life in a different way. That's why I picked this topic, and I believe that I'm a credible enough source to where I know what I'm talking about. And according to this graph, the source I got is from the Immigration and Custom Enforcement, or ICE. The blue represents all the criminal deportation, which sounds like a bad thing, but it could be anything from like a speeding ticket or even jaywalking. And with all that, that could easily ruin a good family. If it's the father losing the dependent, it's just a bad thing. And the red is just the total of deportations of that year. 2016 has been the lowest since 2008, I believe. I don't know, this graph went 2009, but I believe it's 2008. But from 2016 to 2000, to now, that number has increased by at least 100,000. So now I'd like to inform you about the hardships that these families have to go through. The beginning thing I would like to talk about is money management and how they have to try to get money even though they don't have any way of getting it. Especially the majority that doesn't have a work visa, which is basically a permission from the government allowing them to live in this country legally, just as long as they are able to work. But in the process of doing that, it takes about 6 to 7 years before you can even get it processed. And the money that it takes to hire all the lawyers and hire all the time you need to do that, it's working. And with that said, another thing I would like to talk about is the way they live without the work visa. Most people believe that the immigrants come here just to take jobs, just to do their jobs and just ruin the country apparently, but they're just out here trying to live in general, because over there in Mexico it's horrible. The way that they're treated down there, is not humane, is how I should say it, because getting a job down there is very, very stressful. The only place where you could find a decent job and be able to get a decent amount of money to supply your family, let's say like 3 or 4, is at an oil rig, which pays maybe about seven to like 8 pesos, which isn't even that much here. And the next thing I would like to talk about is the emotional scars that are left on the children of these illegal immigrants. Personally, I've lost my father due to deportation back when I was 12 years old. It would happen on a Sunday night, and we were just watching the news. I believe It was CNN, and we just, I just, there was a knocking at the door, and my dad went to go answer, and all else I could remember was just my mom telling me to stay in the couch and don't move or else I'm grounded for the year, and she just ran outside, and I don't know how long it was. It's been like, it felt like forever, but in reality, it's probably like 15 or 20 minutes. But when she came back, she was bawling her eyes out. And I just couldn't deal with that. It was so painful, both emotionally and mentally. And it definitely left a toll on my mother, because now she had to take care of two kids. She had to get, at one point she was working three jobs. And it was, according to a phone interview I had with Jonathan A. Bartel, that is what he hears on a daily basis. And he's, according to him, he says that it's emotionally draining for as well, hearing all these heartbreaking stories. And so, in conclusion, I was like, I hope I got to you guys about how immigration is not really a bad thing towards the immigrants. They're just trying to survive. And while everybody assumes that they're just criminals, the majority of them are all good people. And I just wanted to hopefully inform you guys about how the other side lives. Thank you. Any questions?
Were you able to stay in contact with your father?
No. He made a Facebook like 2 or 3 years ago, and that's how me and him started talking. But other than that, they wouldn't even let me see him.
Is your father in the U.S. now?
No, he's still in Mexico. Now that I'm 20, I'm able to help him apply for a visa because I'm a legal adult now. But he doesn't want to come back. Like, he says it's pointless now.
Have you ever thought about going to Mexico to see your dad?
I definitely did. Mm-hmm. When I was 18, I went down there, and he was talking to my mom's aunts and cousins, and they were telling him that I was down there, and so I went to go visit him, and I looked just like him, but he's way darker. I couldn't find the photo.